Hi, I'm Jared. Welcome to Fun Science Demos. In a previous video, we talked about physical changes. And a physical change is where I can change what something looks like. I have a piece of paper, I crumble it into a ball, I've changed what it looks like. I don't change what it's made of, I don't change the stuff it's made of, I don't change the matter that this paper is made of. Through science, we've discovered, yes, we can change things physically, but we can also change things chemically. So let's show you a chemical change. I need to put on my safety glasses. I need to get a match. And I'm going to try to change this paper chemically. Blow that out, let that go a little bit, and I'll blow this out. So we've zoomed in so you can take a closer look at what we're left with. And what are we left with? We have all of this stuff that started out like this white paper, but it changed chemically. It's no longer that white paper. It's black and charred, and even the match head is different too. That's because it's changed chemically. One of the clues that a chemical change has taken place is that a new substance is created. We could see that new substance when we burn the paper, but sometimes we can't see that new substance. Sometimes that new substance is invisible and just goes into the air. Well, today we're going to try and take a closer look at that invisible substance that can be created in a chemical change. A lot of times when you hear chemical change, you think explosions and fire. But chemical changes happen around us all the time, and we may not even think about it. Take, for example, this piece of bread. So we've zoomed in, and what do you notice? Well, I notice all these open spaces, these little pockets. Some are small here, but this one's big. Well, where did those come from? All of these air pockets were caused by a chemical change. When I mixed all of the ingredients together to make this bread, a new substance was created. So why does bread rise when you mix all the ingredients together? Well, that's because a chemical change is taking place. All the ingredients mixed together and a new substance is created. That new substance is carbon dioxide gas. One of the ingredients in bread that's responsible for that chemical change taking place is a living thing. I'm going to pour some of it out. Right there. What is that? We've zoomed in so that you can see a pile of yeast. And believe it or not, this yeast is alive, but it needs the right conditions so that it can grow. So here's our yeast, and we have warm water and sugar. The warm water and sugar are going to give us the right conditions for the yeast to grow, and we're going to see if we can capture the new substance that's created when a chemical change takes place. Now I'm going to put a couple scoops of sugar into the water. Stir it up. You can see I'm a little messy. That's okay. And while that's dissolving, I'm going to dump some yeast into my bottle using my funnel. So I have the two things I want to mix together. I have my yeast and I have my warm sugar water. And I have a balloon that I want to put on top of my bottle so that I can capture the carbon dioxide that's given off because of our chemical change. So here we go. Let's dump some of our warm sugar water in. That's good enough. Let's take my balloon, really stretch it over the top. I want to get my balloon down as far as I can on the bottle, and I'm going to use a rubber band just to make sure it stays on top of the bottle. So I'm going to swirl it around just to mix things up, and it doesn't really look like anything's happening, but that's okay. This chemical change is slow. It takes time. It's kind of like watching bread rise. It's important to keep in mind that chemical changes can happen slow or fast. In this case, the new substance being created is carbon dioxide gas, and you can see it's not happening that quickly at all. So why don't we try and mix two different things together to create a chemical change which also creates carbon dioxide gas, but this is going to happen much more quickly. The two things we're going to mix together to make this fast chemical change is vinegar and baking soda. So I need to put my safety glasses on. And this chemical change happens so quickly, we're going to have to slow it down or delay it a little bit by putting the baking soda in a tissue and then dropping it into the vinegar. If we didn't do that, as soon as the baking soda mixes with the vinegar, we'd have a really fast chemical change, a new substance would be created, and we'd have a big mess on our hands. So I'm gonna take a tissue, and most tissues actually have two layers of tissue that I can separate. I pull the tissue apart, and now I have a nice thin layer of tissue. I take my baking soda, put a healthy amount of baking soda on my tissue, and now I just bundle it up, take a twist tie, and I have a package of baking soda. Open the vinegar, pour some into the baggie. All right, so I'm ready to go. Now, just before I drop in the baking soda into the baggie, we're gonna zoom in so you can take a closer look at what's happening. All right, let's drop it in. Now, we have to make sure the baggie gets sealed completely. So I'm gonna take my time and press. And I can, if I look, I can see the chemical change is already starting. I see some fizzing, some bubbling. Well, those bubbles are carbon dioxide gas. Remember, a chemical change, something new is created, a new substance is created. And in this case, it's carbon dioxide gas. Same carbon dioxide gas that is created with the yeast and the sugar water. It's happening a little slowly because the vinegar is seeping in through the tissue. And now what should happen, that new carbon dioxide gas should start to fill the baggie. If I want to speed it up a little bit, I can shake it. And we can see the baggie's going to start to fill up. I wonder what will happen if enough carbon dioxide gas is created to plump the baggie up. What do you think's going to happen? The baggie's looking pretty full. So did you hear that pop? What was the pop? Well, remember, the baking soda was mixing with the vinegar to create a chemical change, and in a chemical change, something new is created. In this case, it was carbon dioxide gas. And so much carbon dioxide gas was created inside the baggie couldn't keep itself closed. The air forced its way out, popping out of the bag. Remember, carbon dioxide gas, hey, we actually have something happening here, but remember, it's slowly happening. Here, it was much more quickly. So we've turned the overhead lights off a little bit so we can better see what's going on inside of our bottle. But take a look at our balloon. Remember when we first poured in the sugar water into the yeast, nothing really seemed to happen, but our balloon's a lot bigger. What does that mean? It means all of this carbon dioxide gas, because of a chemical change, is being created and it's filling our balloon, and you can see it's filled our bottle. And take a look at the bottle. We've zoomed in so you can really see this up close, but take a look. The tiny bubbles in the bottle of carbon dioxide gas look very similar to these tiny little craters or holes in the bread. That's because that's what made all of these little pockets in the bread. Carbon dioxide gas from the chemical change of yeast reacting with the sugar. It's important to remember that chemical changes are happening around us all the time. Do you remember how we said yeast is a living thing? Well, we're a living thing, and chemical changes are happening inside of us all the time. If you want to learn more about chemical changes in living things, check out our links in the video description. Science is so cool when new things are created, and I can actually eat some of those things. Thanks for watching.